Taylor Swift takes on Apple, and a cyber attack grounds an airline. Here's your tech top three and what you need to know this week. It took Taylor Swift just 17 hours to make Apple change its policy on paying musicians during the Apple Music trial period. When the music streaming service debuts June 30th, the company didn't plan to pay artists during the free 90-day trial. After Swift publicly complained, Apple SVP Eddie Q changed the policy, and now Apple will compensate the artists. A cyber attack on a Polish airline canceled 10 flights, delayed dozens others, and grounded 1,400 passengers. LOT said it encountered an IT attack that affected its ground operations systems, stopping them from creating flight plans for outbound flights. Usually when we hear about a denial of service attack, it means a website is unavailable. But this incident highlights that these kinds of attacks could have much more serious implications in the physical world. A hardware failure at the U.S. Department of State threw plans into chaos for hundreds of thousands of travelers seeking visas. The hardware was involved in biometric processing and was part of the technology responsible for issuing 50,000 U.S. visas a day. About two-thirds of visa-issuing facilities are back online, but the State Department still hasn't said exactly what went wrong. I travel a lot for work, and when I'm at airports, I can't help but marvel at the technology and engineering precision that goes into airplanes. We saw some of these amazing machines at the Paris Air Show. Boeing's new 787-9 Dreamliner caught a lot of attention with its near-vertical takeoff. There was also the Airbus A380, a double-decker super jumbo jet that can carry about 500 passengers up to 10,000 miles. While most eyes were on these behemoths, a much smaller plane made a much bigger impact. It was Airbus's EFAN 2.0, a fully electric, battery-powered two-seater. There are a few reasons why this is such a big deal. Aviation fuel is expensive for gas-powered planes. Even a small single-engine plane could cost $400 to fill up. Will this electric plane replace it? With only about a 100-mile range, certainly not. What it does do is prove there is hope for electric planes. Airbus sees this plane as something to train pilots with, and it would be a good option for beginners to practice their takeoffs and landings in, while longer flights remain reserved for gas counterparts. Often overlooked is the pollution from airplanes. In 2013, aircraft emitted 705 tons of carbon dioxide. Airbus plans to invest 20 million euro to commercialize the EFAN by late 2017. The company also wants to manufacture a 100-passenger electric plane by 2050. I'm Nick Barber, and that's a wrap.